Mr. and Mrs. Griffin, thanks for coming in to see me today.
Is this about Chris? We know he's been struggling lately.
Well, let me put it this way. Parents of a failing student say what?
What?
No, Peter, wait!
Nope, too late. He said it. I'm marking it. Didn't get the woos. They're very smart. Asian. Maybe they didn't understand me. I don't know. The point is, Chris's grades aren't improving, and just yesterday he caused a little ruckus in his history class.
Alexander Hamilton was right!
We here feel that the best solution is for Chris to attend something called vocational school.
Don't you have to be Italian to go to one of those schools?
There will be plenty of those jokes later in the episode.
I can't believe I have to go to vocational school. Does this mean I'm a failure?
No, sweetie. It means that we're failures.
Can I help you?
Yes, I am here for my first day of vocational school.
Right this way.
This notepad and pencil is from Mr. Tony over there.
All right, settle down, you yucks. We got a new student, Chris Griffin, so everybody give him an A.
A!
Look at that. Your first day and you got all A's. Come here, let me pinch your cheek. Got all A's.
You're expressing affection and dominance.
Griffin, where's the uchi or squalata at the end? You Jewish?
No.
It true if you're Jewish, they cut your dong off with an axe?
My uncle's Jewish. Friggin' mess that guy.
Hey, Chip Chop, it's 9:30. Let's start thinking lunch.
We do a nice sit-down thing here. Little piccata, little veal. Rocco here learned to cook in the joint.
Okay, everybody dirty up your hands. We'll eat in 10.
Wow, this is way better than that barber school I went to where I couldn't stop pumping the chair.
Just a bit off the top and shorter on the sides.
We're just gonna be pumping today.
All right, Chris. A big part of being a mechanic is being completely shocked when somebody hasn't had a particular item on a restaurant menu.
Hey, Chrissy, we're thinking about going over to Pete's. You want a bread sandwich?
What's a bread sandwich?
What? You never had a bread sandwich from Pete's?
Everyone who's not currently in the room, get over here. Griffin's never had a Pete's bread sandwich.
Whoa, what? You never had a bread sandwich from Pete's?
We've covered this. Somebody tell me what it is.
What do you think it is? It's three pieces of bread. Me, I like a piece of sourdough on top, piece of sourdough on bottom, and a nice piece of wheat in the middle.
I like to go rye, rye, rye. I'm a rye guy.
Hey, you guys going to Pete's? Someone give me a bread sandwich.
Griffin's never had one.
What?
What?
Guys, I just called Pete's. They're closed forever.
What?
Who answered the phone?
Mr. and Mrs. G, thanks so much for having us over for dinner.
Oh, it's our pleasure. Chris has said so many nice things about you.
Maybe one or two of them are true.
Chris, tell your mom and dad about the story you wrote.
Oh, I don't know.
Chris, come on. Don't be shy.
Okay. It's called The Black Duck.
The Black Duck. You ever seen a black duck? I've seen a brown duck, a yellow duck, a white duck with a green head. It has all kinds of ducks. This kid thinks of a black one.
Come on, it's just a stupid story, guys.
Hey, if it was such a stupid story, why would it have such a well-rounded protagonist? Remember what I told you behind the garage?
That you might be gay?
What? No, I didn't say that. The imagination on this one. Black ducks, I'm gay. What's next? Martians? Little green Martian people?
Oh, Chris, I'm so happy you have so many wonderful new friends. He was very unpopular in high school.
Oh, yeah, you know, he's strong, too. He takes care of a lot of stuff for us.
Stuff?
Yeah, he took care of one of our competitors.
Mr. Firestone says hello.
Ow! 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 Stop it!
Oh my God, Chris! That's silly, but it's still murder!
Relax. That Michelin man had no family.
He came from tires, Ma!
Chris, there's something your father and I want to talk to you about. Chris? Chris?
Sorry, I only answer to Chrissy now.
Fine. Chrissy?
Yeah, Ma?
Can you stop lifting your rusty weights while we talk to you?
Chris, we're worried about you and your new friends.
Pop, don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it. Okay.
No, Peter, it's not okay. Chris, we don't want you in the mafia.
Hey, I'm in waste management.
Chris, you need to be back in high school where you belong, but Principal Shepard won't let you back in, and we don't know what to do.
What do I need school for? Tony Danza never went to school, and he played a guy named Tony on 4 different TV shows.
Lois, let me handle this. Chris, I'm going to say this in a way an Italian mechanic would understand. You're breaking your mother's heart!
Ma! Why didn't you say so? Ma! I'll take care of it.
What have you got there?
A guy letting me back into school says what?
What? Damn it!
Okay, see you on Monday.